You know you're late. Don't give me that. People have been waiting for you. Well, it's a good job you're worth the wait, isn't it? Would you believe that I first announced the pending launch of the Virto R Infinio hearing aid in August of 2024, with Phonak hinting at a release towards the end of that year, so 12 months ago. So thank you, Phonak, for making me look like a bit of a Wally here. Now, for reasons which aren't important enough for me to share in today's video, its release was obviously delayed. I don't know why I've said that, it's clearly been delayed. But you'll be delighted to hear that I finally have an update for you on when exactly you'll be able to get your hands on this incredible new technology, and also why you'll be pleased that you waited. This is big. So today's big announcement is all around the Virto R Infinio hearing aid, which has a few firsts for Phonak, all of which I will cover in today's video. It sports a push button, twin microphones for directionality and better understanding in noise. These here are the charging contacts, plus there's an LED here in the center, which makes it all look very futuristic. And in my opinion, nothing like a hearing aid. Now, something I'm particularly excited to tell you is the fact that it has all of the same features as Phonak's receiver and canal hearing aid, the Audéo Infinio, meaning that there is no compromise on rechargeability, hearing in noise, tap control features, accelerometers, etc., etc. And why do I say this? Well, these are normally features that you'll have to go without if choosing an in-the-ear model of hearing aid. For those of you unfamiliar with how these hearing aids are made, firstly, you'll need to have an impression taken of your ear. That then needs to be sent over to Phonak HQ, and the entire process from start to finish takes around about 2 weeks in total. As far as this customization goes, Phonak have also leveled up to ensure that these hearing aids won't only be physically personalized to the shape of your ear, and then acoustically personalized to your hearing test results, but as far as I'm aware, they're also the first manufacturers to acoustically personalize them to the shape of your ear too. I've had to record this about 10 times to make sure I've said that right, so watch it back if it doesn't make sense. So what I mean by that exactly is that Phonak are boasting that they're custom built using biometric calibration, which essentially minimizes sound leakage and maximizes sound quality. And I have to say, it's pretty awesome how they do it. This biometric calibration process uses advanced imaging technology and creates a detailed map of your ear, scanning 1600 data points and then predicting how sound will bounce around it before it hits the hearing aid microphone. Not only that, but Phonak's research is also showing that they'll turn out 15% smaller than their previous in-the-ear model of hearing aids, making them the smallest rechargeable ITE hearing aids on the market. Well, so they say, but let's see how this works in practice. Now, I'm pretty sure that that is everything worth mentioning from a physical perspective. So let's dive into the new features built inside these hearing aids, starting with sound quality. If you manage to keep up to date with developments in hearing aid technology, then you'll be aware that there are sometimes incremental changes that we see when a new hearing aid is released. And then every few years, there are big changes that we see too. Now, these big changes tend to come when a new chip is introduced, and this is exactly what we're seeing from today's new hearing aids from Phonak. With the introduction of the ERA chip, and with this new chip, Phonak are shouting from the rooftops about a few key developments. Firstly, we're seeing the introduction of APD 3.0, which is a new audiological fitting model that uses up-to-date research, so Phonak say, on providing the most appropriate amount of sound needed to compensate for your specific hearing loss without it sounding either unnatural or overwhelming. And Phonak's research states that 93% of those that have trialled this hearing aid prefer it to the sound of other leading competitors. 93% is a pretty huge number. Moving on to AutoSense, which is one of my favourite adaptive programs out there. And this technology utilises sophisticated algorithms to continuously analyse the acoustic environment around you, making real-time adjustments to optimise the sound in terms of clarity and comfort. Phonak had developed this even further in the Infinios, but the Audéo, the receiver and canal version, by moving on to AutoSense 6.0, which we saw an enhancement in speech understanding by around 16%, and a reduction in listening effort by up to 45%, so big numbers here. However, the good news is, in the year that we've waited for this new technology to come out, they've only gone and developed it further still, retraining it with 18 times more real-world sound recordings, and therefore delivering 25% more precision. So what does that mean in English? It means that the hearing aids are doing more to understand the environment around you and selecting the most appropriate setting to be on. And dare I say it, that this means it will be the first in-ear hearing aid to be better at this job than their behind-the-ear counterpart. Big statement there. Now, it is incredibly difficult to be excited about a hearing aid charger. So I'm not going to be. It's simple, it's easy to use, the hearing aids snap into position using magnets, and it will accommodate every sized hearing aid to the smallest to full shell. Charging will take around 3 hours for a full charge and will provide 30 hours of life. If you're interested in a telecoil, then you'll need to find another hearing aid. That is all. However, something they do have is Bluetooth. And Phonak's Bluetooth is already unique, as they are the only manufacturers out there to use classic Bluetooth version 5.3, allowing you to connect to any Bluetooth device, not just a smartphone. Yet they found a way to make themselves even more unique. In fact, they found several ways. Firstly, Infinio's universal compatibility means it connects with all Bluetooth-enabled devices, including smartphones, tablets, and computers. This integration supports a wide range of audio codecs, ensuring high-quality streaming regardless of the sound source, and supports dual streaming too, allowing you to connect to multiple devices simultaneously, which isn't possible from any other hearing aid manufacturer. And secondly, the Infinio also offers hands-free calling, which is again pretty limited compared to other hearing aid manufacturers, with this new chip ensuring instant connectivity so your hearing aids are ready to use immediately after startup. And Phonak is stating that this is the lowest latency that they've ever been able to provide, meaning that there's no noticeable delay when switching between different audio sources, i.e. your television and your phone or your laptop or your iPad. Thirdly, Phonak are boasting that this new chip allows for 6 times the transmission power of previous models, providing a far more stable and faster connection. This increased power ensures consistent audio quality and connectivity over longer distances so that apparently you'll be able to enjoy uninterrupted streaming and phone calls, even if your phone is in another room or perhaps in your sports bag. And then finally, some news that you have all been waiting to hear. Infinio is also Auracast ready, which I'm pretty sure is going to change your guys' listening experiences forever. And I do not say this lightly. In short, you'll see an improvement in the Bluetooth capabilities with your phone when it comes to sound quality and battery consumption. And that's whether you're listening to phone calls, music, and the radio or podcasts, all whilst you can keep your phone in your pocket, giving you a truly hands-free experience. But I have to tell you that this is not everything. Where this tech will really take off is in a public venue with a built-in Auracast transmitter. What's that, I hear you cry? Well, this new form of transmitter is specifically designed to work with any new LE audio technology and essentially will send any signal to your hearing aids from the transmitter, such as if you walk into a football stadium and want to hear the commentator, or perhaps if you walk onto a train station and you want to hear the train announcements, or even if you head over to a museum tour and want to hear the tour guide with perfect clarity and distinction. Over these next few years, it's already started to happen. I've got one in my clinic and I'm going to visit the UK's first train station with one installed this very week. So you'll be starting to see these Auracast transmitters installed, and Auracast broadcasted audio will replace the century-old loop systems built into public venues, allowing for multiple hearing aid users to simultaneously connect to audio in these public spaces, all with this improvement in sound quality and lower battery consumption. And trust me, like I said earlier, this is going to be a game changer. Not just for those of you with hearing aids, but I predict that this will be built into regular headphones too. Now, something worth noting, something that is incredibly important for you to be aware of, is that whilst this is built into the Infinios, it isn't yet activated. Please, Phonak, can you activate it? I've been reassured that this will be done in the future with a simple and free firmware update. So does this really matter? Not necessarily just yet, because there aren't enough transmitters out there for it to make a significant difference. But I promise you, as soon as it is activated, you will hear about it first here on the Hearing Tracker YouTube channel. As with most Phonak technology, the Virtos are available in 4 different technology levels, from the 90s, 70s, 50s and 30s, with the former being the most advanced of the family. Going for a more advanced hearing aid gives you access to more features, more automation, better hearing in noise, and more clarity. I would take a look through this table to see which features resonate with you and then chat to your audiologist about which is going to be the best hearing aid for not just your hearing test results, but also your lifestyle too. Now, discussing the waterproofing of a hearing aid almost seems irrelevant nowadays. Yet the reason that all manufacturers all feel the need to boast how robust their hearing aids are is because they used to be terrible. A drop of sweat when you were working out or a particularly humid day would send a hearing aid into overdrive. So for an active person or somebody that likes to spend time outdoors or near water, you'll be pleased to hear that these hearing aids have an IP68 rating, which is pretty much the industry standard nowadays. And it means that they can technically be submerged in a meter and a half of water for 30 minutes and they should still function afterwards. Now, please don't interpret this as me saying or suggesting that you should go swimming wearing them, but this rating should ensure less breakdowns and far more reliability. Now, my full review on this technology won't be out for a while, as those of you that regularly tune into this channel know that I prefer to share the good, the bad, and the ugly after I've fitted these hearing aids to a few patients' ears. So that's when you'll get a real detailed review. In the meantime, I wouldn't recommend making any decisions about buying hearing aids until you've watched this video covering the best hearing aids of this year.